This month marks 100 years since Australia's east and west were joined for the first time by rail, an incredible engineering feat completed in the midst of World War I. Today, the Trans-Australia Railway is as important as ever, helping to shift huge volumes of freight across some of the country's toughest terrain. Andrew Lund went aboard.
The breathtaking beauty of the Nullarbor, harsh, inhospitable, and the heart of the Trans-Australian Railway. Here, trains up to 1.8 kilometres long labour their way across the continent, pulled by powerful 4,000 horsepower engines and guided by drivers who know the line off by heart.
You've always got to sort of know where you are on the track so that you can work out how you're meant to be driving it.
The railway linking Australia's east and west boasts the longest stretch of straight track anywhere in the world. 478 kilometres without a single bend. The figures are staggering, even more so when you consider it was built at the height of World War I.
Just a massive labour-intensive project. 1,000 horses, 1,000 camels and about 2,000 workers.
The line between Port Augusta and Kalgoorlie was a promise made to persuade Western Australia to sign up for Federation. Completed 100 years ago this month, it's now one of the nation's major transport arteries. And drivers like Dave Priest enjoy conditions far removed from those endured by their predecessors.
You wouldn't want to be a train driver then, shoveling coal all the time, and how hot would have that been in the middle of summer going across the Nullarbor shoveling coal or something? God, I couldn't think of nothing worse.
Much has changed in the past 100 years. Cook, near the West Australian border, once boasted a school and a hospital, but it's now inhabited by just a handful of people employed by rail giant Pacific National.
Temperatures here in summer can reach up to 50 degrees, and with the nearest shop more than 450 kilometres away, staff bring their own supplies while water is tankered in twice a week.
Train enthusiasts will mark the official centenary of the rail connection later this month as the federal government looks to the nation's next big project.
100 years after the Transcontinental Railway, we're finally getting on to the job of the Melbourne-Brisbane Inland Rail project. We're going to see construction start this year.
But it's unlikely to carry the same symbolism as the line that united the nation a century ago and still serves as a vital link across the emptiness of Central Australia. On a train on the Nullarbor Plain, Andrew Lund, Nine News.